Hey there, I am Neff, and in this video, I'd like to share with you a HubSpot support bot that I'd like to remix, and I'm going to use yours truly, the Typebot docs, and I will be creating an assistant bot to help people like us, Typebot users, to try to find answers a lot faster without having to use the search navigation. So to give you a quick visual, here I am in the Typebot docs. So instead of going up here and searching for an answer or navigating through this navigation pane, I thought it would be wonderful to include a chatbot that can help us find the answer that we're looking for within the documentation. So what I'll do now is walk you through an example of what it looks like, and then I'll share with you behind the curtain how I put the bot together. So here I am inputting this question: how can I bind a custom domain to your Typebot in the share tab? So let's go ahead and run that and see what response we get. All right, so we get an answer. It seems to be pretty accurate. And a huge shout out to Baptiste for inserting a parser that transforms a markdown link into an actual hyperlink in here. So this is super useful because now the chatbot or the AI can return the link to the user if they want to go ahead and navigate to that. So let's go ahead and click on that. And there we go. So it takes us directly to the help article or the doc where it goes over how to bind a custom domain to the Typebot under the share tab. So that's really cool. So let's go ahead and say that yes, this was a helpful answer. And let's ask it another question. Let's ask it. Okay, so this time I'm going to ask it for step-by-step instructions on how to insert hidden variables in my Typebot. So let's give this a whirl and see what kind of response we get. All right, so let's have a quick look. It says to insert hidden variables in your Typebot, you can follow these steps. So it says in the Typebot editor, go to the variable section. Create a new variable by clicking on the plus button. Give your variable a name and choose a hidden option. Save your variable. So far, this doesn't seem like the type of answer I was expecting. What I was hoping to get is how to insert a hidden variable within the Typebot script in the JavaScript. So the nice thing is that if I do want some more detailed instructions, I can click here within variables and then try to get some more information about, how to fill this in. But let's pretend that the information on how to do that, on how to insert a hidden variable, much like is nicely defined here. Let's pretend that that wasn't provided, but that was an option that we can do in our chatbot. So if that was the case, let's say that the answer was not helpful, right? So I'm going to click on no. And then I'm prompted by submitting a help request via email. So let's go ahead and say yes. Let's go ahead and report this as an issue. So I'll fill in my name and my email address, and then I'll insert the nature of the issue, and then I can upload a screenshot or a recording. That's pretty much it. After that, the report of the issue is going to be sent via email, and I actually put in the support email at Typebot, so I don't want to bother Baptiste with this little fun exercise. That's pretty much the flow here. So we can keep letting users engage with the AI bot to get information about the documentation on this help article on the Typebot documentation. So now what I'd like to do is just kind of show you behind the curtain and show you how I put this together. All right, so here we are inside of Typebot. So first thing that we do is we put in a greeting, and then we tell the user that we're not pretending to be a human, we're actually a new AI bot. So if we can't give you the answer, we're going to connect you to our support team, right, via that support ticket. So then we make a call to retune. So in this block, what we're doing is we are initiating a new chatbot altogether. Well, I suppose it's not really a whole new chatbot, but rather a chat thread as retune describes it. So we're using this API section that you see up here. And then the next thing that we do is we ask for the user to insert their question in this text input block. Then after that, what we do is we run another post request over to retune. But this time, instead of initiating the chat thread, we are starting a conversation. So here is the code that I used. And so the thing that you need to know here is that when you run this chat thread up here, the response gives you a thread ID. So that thread ID, you'll use it down here in the body of your JSON response or your JSON body. And then for input, you put whatever question that the user input. So if we head back to Chatbot or to Typebot and go over to the body, you'll see here is where I served the retune thread ID, and here's where I served the user answer, or rather the user's question. So to test if this thing actually works, I put in some of these sample variables. And when you do the test request, you should see a status code of 200. That means that it's successful. And what you want to do is then save the value that got returned, right? You want to save that as the bot's answer, or what I call the assistant answer. So then if we head back to our amazing chat flow, you'll see that the assistant answer is plugged in right here. And then we followed up with whether the assistant answer was actually useful, right? We want to make sure that it was, because if it wasn't, we want to point the user to submit a help request via email. So before we do that, we actually put the response over into this Google Sheet. So let me show you what that looks like. All right, so here you can see two test responses were captured because I clicked on no, the answer was not helpful. So this is really interesting, and I think this could be very useful for a lot of people building a chatbot, because what this does is creates a feedback loop. So what we see here is that we know that this answer was not helpful. We see the user's question or their request or their query, and then we see where the disconnect was, right? So this is an opportunity to improve on the AI's bot answer. So what we're trying to do is, for the next time this sort of question gets asked, we want to provide a better answer than what we provided here. And what's awesome about retune is that you can train it from curated QA examples, right? So here we can say, you know, we can put in the user's question or their query that they put into Typebot. And then here we can put in the correct answer. So when we save it, then retune will look it up, right? And then provide an even better answer to the user for the next example, or for the next time that happens. So that's pretty much it in a nutshell. The one thing I do want to note here is that there's so many different ways you can configure this, right? And that's pretty much based on your support channels. So for instance, if somebody says, okay, no, the answer was not helpful, then something that you can do is instead of directing them to report their issue and then submit their issue via email to your support team, what you can do is just guide them to a phone call to call your support desk. And you can configure that within business hours with a little bit of JS code. Or you can set up something different. Maybe it's an alert via Slack. Or maybe your team focuses on fielding requests via Twitter messages or WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger. There's so many different channels where you can take that information and then send it over to your support team. I think what is interesting to note here is that you can also do live chat. And I messed around a little bit with Chatwoot, which is another app that connects with Typebot, but it's not quite a cohesive experience because, well, let me just show you. All right, so here's an example for Chatwoot, which connects with your live chat experience. So let me just put in my name and my email, and I'll put in my phone number here. All right, so down here, you'll notice that a different icon appeared. And when we open it, we get sort of this interface. So a couple things to note here. You need to create a Chatwoot account, and you have to kind of make the connection between your Typebot and your Chatwoot account, and that's done with some sort of key or ID. So let's go ahead and just type in a quick message like the classic hello world. And going over to Chatwoot, you can see my message came in. It actually pulled up the previous one that I tested out earlier today. So it has hi there, which you see here, and then hello world, right? Which you see here. So something that's not clear to me is that it seems like the Chatwoot widget kind of comes up and it's not really native. It doesn't look like it's native to Typebot, right? Because it's kind of within the Typebot itself, like you see right here. In any case, I haven't tested it out on a website yet, but it seems to me that it would be kind of like a separate experience altogether. It sort of seems like the Typebot bubble would kind of disappear and be replaced by this Chatwoot experience. And what I don't really like, or what I'm not a huge fan of, is that once you're in live chat, there's kind of no going back to Typebot. It's kind of like a handoff, right? So that's what I see so far. I haven't dug in a whole lot into it, but that's sort of the impression that I'm getting so far. All right, kind of went off track there, but I thought that might be useful to some of you out there that want to create some sort of support team handoff from the AI chatbot. All right, if you have any questions, any comments, I'd love to hear from you guys. Put them in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.